Welcome to the Forecheck. I'm Carley Johnston, joined this week again by Art Regner. Art, I always love having you on.
It's my favorite show to do, Carly, and you're my favorite hostess.
Love it.
Or host, whatever.
Same thing. So it is All-Star Week, you guys. Jimmy Howard was selected to represent the Detroit Red Wings in this year's All-Star Game. Art, he has been an All-Star this year.
Well, he certainly has been. I mean, Jimmy Howard, well-deserved honor. I mean, this is something that he's really worked towards and strived to be. And, you know, for a team that has trouble scoring goals like the Red Wings, you need to be solid in net, and Jimmy certainly has been.
This is not his first rodeo, and we will be rooting him on here in Hockey Town. And with that, we are past the halfway mark this season. So we want to kind of do a little back check in this episode of the Forecheck, if you will. Starting off with the beginning of the season, Art, the Red Wings didn't start so hot. They were struggling. They were plagued by injuries.
Well, certainly, and they were certainly plagued by injuries to the back end. I mean, arguably their top four defensemen. I know Cromwell played, but you know, their top four guys were out, and some youngsters had to come in and you know, played and tried very, very well. But again, you know, learning to play defense in the NHL is very, very difficult. And when you have four pretty much rookies, guys that are don't have a lot of NHL experience playing it for the first time, it started to take its toll on the team. But once they started to get healthy, once Mike Green started coming back and Trevor Daley started coming back and Danny DeKeyser started coming back, the Red Wings started to turn it around. But really, the big thing for the Red Wings, especially on the back end, is the play of Mike Green. I mean, he is a premier player. He's one of the best offensive defensemen of his generation. Let me get that out. And the Red Wings' record with Mike Green in it, as opposed to when he's not in the lineup, is extraordinary. There's a huge gap. I know he downplays it, but the fact is that he can make that first pass out of his own end. He can get the puck out of his zone. He's offensive-minded. He's always playing go, go, go. So Mike Green, I think, especially on the back end, has been the big story defensively for the Red Wings. But when you add Trevor Daley and Danny DeKeyser, who's really played well since last season, he's been a plus player. Detroit's defense needs experience. They need those veterans in the lineup, and it's just not about having Mike Green back. They need everybody back there.
Right, and the Red Wings weren't just struggling with injuries on the blue line. It was up front as well. In the game against the Colorado Avalanche in December, Anthony Mantha stuck up for Dylan Larkin and broke his hand and was out for weeks.
He was out for weeks, and it was too bad because he was just starting to pick up and score some goals. You know, he led the Red Wings in goals last year at 24. They need Anthony Mantha. He has a wicked shot, and I think that he's learned that he has to be a little calmer, I guess. But Mantha is big-time scorer. We know that. And then you throw in guys like Athanasiu, who's also having a really, really good season. You know, I think off the top of my head, I think the statistic is that he's gone pointless in only three consecutive games a couple of times a season. So he's really picked it up. And I think that what we're seeing here is a maturation process for the Red Wings, especially with their forward core. Some of these guys that were inconsistent are really starting to pick it up now. You know, look at Bertuzzi. You know, Bertuzzi again has played very, very well. You know, got a hat trick, his first in his 100th game against the Minnesota Wild. So there is a semblance of a team here. You know, to fans, I mean, everybody wants them to be, you know, the Red Wings. And the Red Wings are a team that are perennial Stanley Cup champions. They're going to get there, but it might take them some time. But we are seeing the genesis of this team starting to come together.
You mentioned Bertuzzi's hat trick, but you can't forget Franz Nielsen's hat trick. Remember at Little Caesars Arena, the first hat trick at Little Caesars Arena by a Red Wings player. That was a pretty big game.
Well, right. Now, Nielsen, too, has actually picked it up. He's great in the room. Obviously, he wouldn't be wearing that A if he wasn't. But, you know, he's a great two-way player, and he does everything kind of effortlessly. So sometimes you have a tendency to forget about him. But just as soon as you forget about him, bam, you know, he comes back and makes you pay for it. So Franz Nielsen probably wants a few more points. Started off a little bit slowly, but he is starting to pick it up, which obviously the Red Wings need.
And you can't mention the first half of the season without mentioning Dylan Larkin. He's a guy who's really stepped up to the plate with that new A on his chest.
Well, certainly. I mean, Dylan Larkin, and we've talked about this before, Dylan Larkin is from here. Mm-hmm. He grew up a Red Wings fan. Mm-hmm. He played for the University of Michigan. He's about as Detroit can get. But he wants to be the man that elevates the Red Wings back to where he believes they belong, which is perennial Stanley Cup champions. And he's doing everything within his power. He's their leading scorer. He also had that 14-point consecutive streak, which at the time was the longest active streak in the NHL. It's since been broken, but then he's picked up right where he left off. But I think the thing that really epitomizes the season that he had, there's two plays that I would like to talk about. The overtime goal he scored against Toronto in Toronto. You know, obviously the mecca of hockey, all you have to do is ask Leaf fans that, but he was able to do that. The Red Wings staged, you know, they had a big lead. Toronto came back on him, but they were end up winning that game on the road, which was huge. And then let's not forget the game where he said he knew, even though Nashville tied it up late in that period when they pulled the goalie, he said they were back at the bench and the Red Wings knew that they were going to win that game to a man. Then he came out with like 30 some odd seconds left, scored that game winning goal against Nashville. And, you know, he was just psyched and jacked. It's just good to see. That's leadership. That's somebody who wants it. That's somebody who will do whatever it takes to make sure that this Red Wings team is not only his team, but a team that all Detroiters can be proud of.
Each week on the Forecheck, we like to highlight a prospect in the Red Wings organization. So, Art, who's it going to be this week?
Well, we always hear about Philip Zadina, and we've talked a lot about him. And I know Joe Valeno is someone. But I think I get more questions asked about who's the Red Wings goalie of the future. And I think right now there's a couple of guys, you know, Keith Petrozelli we've talked about. We've talked about Philip Larson, but a guy that you should not sleep on, so to speak, is Caden Fulcher, who is now playing his first year pro for the Toledo Walleye. He's a big goaltender, fantastic story. He was someone the Red Wings invited to development camp when it was still in Traverse City 2 years ago for a professional tryout. They liked what they saw. They invited him to the prospects tournament, and the Red Wings signed him to a contract at that point. He was in the OHL. He won the OHL championship last year, I believe, with Hamilton. And then this year, his first year pro, he's playing for a really good team in Toledo. They've lost less than 10 games. Caden Fulcher's a guy, as I said, big, has done whatever it takes. I know Brian Mahoney-Wilson, the goaltending instructor for the Red Wing organization, really, really likes him, has a good relationship with him. So this is a young man that I think Red Wing fans in the future remember, Caden Fulcher.
Fans, the Red Wings are off due to their bye week, but their next home game is Friday, February 1st against the Toronto Maple Leafs at Little Caesars Arena. The Red Wings will be retiring Reg Kelly's number 4, so make sure you're in your seats at 7 p.m. for the jersey retirement ceremony. Tickets are available at the Xfinity box office or DetroitRedWings.com. That's it for this week's The Forecheck. Art, I had fun.
I had a great time as always, and Reg Kelly, Bobby Orr before Bobby Orr. That's how good he was.
All right, thanks, Art. We'll see you guys next week.